Lee Taylor Program. Brought to you by Pet Milk, America's first evaporated milk. Yes, welcome to the Mary Lee Taylor Program, featuring the story of the week about that lovable pair, Jim and Sally Carter, and the recipe of the week from Mary Lee Taylor's Friendly Kitchen. And speaking of recipes, be sure to send for Mary Lee's latest collection called From Soup to Dessert. All you do to get this grand recipe booklet is print your name and address and the words Soup to Dessert on a postcard and send the card to Mary Lee Taylor, care of this station, or to Pet Milk, St. Louis, Zone 1, Missouri. And make a note of this. Beginning next week, most of you in the Central and Eastern time zones will be hearing the Mary Lee Taylor Program 1/2 hour later. So next Saturday, check your newspaper for the new time. And now it's Mary Lee on NBC, and here she is.
Hello, this is Mary Lee Taylor. In just a minute, we'll hear about a day in Sally Carter's life which she'll never forget, because Jim said...
There's always some kind of a day. Valentine's Day, Mother-in-Law's Day, Feed the Birds Day. This country'd be better off if it weren't so sentimental. Me, I'm just ignoring all of them.
And that was all right with Sally, except, well, one special day she found it a little hard to take. And you'll hear all about it in just a minute. First, though, let me say that the recipe you'll hear right after the story is for a wonderful whipped Pet Milk dessert.
The kind that tastes like it's made with expensive whipping cream and that really melts in your mouth.
And this dessert, Danish fruit pudding, costs only about 6 cents a serving. In fact, the entire meal we're planning today, including dessert, cost just about 34 cents a person.
And one big reason why meals planned by Mary Lee Taylor are so economical is that Mary Lee always uses money-saving Pet Milk, the first evaporated milk. Yes, the first, the original evaporated milk, the standard of quality for more than 64 years, and the first choice in millions of homes throughout America. And now let's go to Capital City and join our young friends, Jim and Sally Carter.
She and Jim had their housing problem solved when the landlady, Mrs. Hackett, arranged to let them have a first-floor apartment with an extra room and a bath, right in the building where they've been living. Sally has even adopted a little stray kitten, and seeing it curled up on a sunny windowsill adds to Sally's feeling of deep contentment. Today, Sally is particularly happy. It's her birthday. And at breakfast, Jim looks at her and says,
Beautiful. You are beautiful this morning.
I am. Thanks.
Radiant. And you look, well, as though you were expecting something wonderful. You're planning to inherit $7 million this morning?
No, only 6.5. For another cup of coffee?
Oh, a quick one, I guess. I'll go see if there's any mail first.
Oh, drink your coffee, darling. I'm up and the mail's just outside the door. One of the many advantages of a first-floor apartment. See, we were lucky to get this place.
Luck had nothing to do with it. You charmed it right out of the landlady. Hey, you want some coffee?
No, thanks. I'm just supposed to have one cup, remember?
Oh, sure. Say, we did get a pile of mail.
Yes, we certainly did.
Well, it can't be the first of the month again, can it? They roll around pretty fast.
No, but... Mr. Carter, it isn't the first of the month. As a matter of fact, it's January 29th.
So it is. None of that mail for me?
No. All mine.
Oh, for the love of Pete, honey, you must have been answering a lot of ads.
Oh, I haven't been answering ads. It's just my morning to get mail.
Must be. And I'll bet I can tell you what's in every one of them. And that big blue one is an invitation to join the Book of the Minute Club.
Oh, you think so?
And the little pink one
is
a notice of an advanced showing of mink coats.
Well, to tell you the truth, I guess maybe it's time for you to be going to work, Jim.
Golly, you're right. Your coat, Mr. Carter, and your hat. Oh, and Mrs. Carter, when you get around to opening that wide white envelope.
Oh, Jim, then you...
Isn't it a free coupon for soap powder?
Oh.
Well, give me a kiss, honey, and I'll shove off.
Okay.
I just might be a little late tonight, Sally.
Late? Tonight?
Uh-huh. We're busy as the dickens at the office.
All right, Jim. Goodbye.
Go on, beautiful.
It's somebody's birthday on birthday. But he forgot me. He just completely, utterly, absolutely didn't give it a thought.
Martha Rarick, can I come in?
Sure, Martha. The door's unlocked.
Oh, don't get up. I just want to get your lemon pie recipe.
Oh, the recipe's in the book, right there on the shelf.
Okay, I see it.
Sit down and have a cup of coffee, Martha, and a cinnamon bisque.
Boy, they look good. Don't mind if I do. No. Sit still, Sally. I'll get myself a cup.
I just think I'll have an extra cup myself while I open my mail to celebrate.
You do have a lot of mail this morning.
Oh, go right ahead. Open it. They're cards. Mostly from my family, I guess. It's my birthday.
Well, congratulations, Sally. But you don't seem very hepped up about it. Going to have a cake or are you going out to celebrate?
Neither. Jim, I mean, we don't believe in this kind of nonsense.
Don't believe in birthdays? Oh, that doesn't sound like you, Sally. I'd expect the works from you. Cake, candles, everything.
Our family at home is sort of like that, but Jim thinks special days are... It's every day that counts, he thinks.
How disagreeable of him.
Why, it's not either. Jim's so nice every day. He doesn't have to be sentimental if he doesn't want to. I don't care a bit.
Okay, Sally. It's your birthday. Me, I like presents.
Oh, listen to this. It's from Rich, my kid brother. He's 13.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted your birthday to be a whiz bang, and I didn't want nothing to stop it. So I got you this candy sack down at the store. Just blow it right up now and pop it. Happy birthday.
Oh, it must be fun to have a family like yours.
Oh, they're wonderful. I miss them so much since they moved away from London. Oh, look, Mom wrote a note. She says, from that day, 24 years ago, when Dr. Babcock put a tiny baby girl in my arms, she's been nothing but a pleasure and a joy to me. A very happy birthday to a very dear daughter.
Oh, and you're the girl who doesn't believe in birthdays. Never mind, Sally. Maybe Jim will remember before the day's over.
I didn't say you forgot. I just said, well, we aren't going to do anything special, that's all.
Miss Carter, Miss Hackett's come for you.
Oh, Mrs. Hackett.
Come in, Mrs. Hackett.
Here it is. Yeah, thank you. For the baby?
A person would think the baby was the only one in this family to hear you talk. I'll bet this package is for me.
It's her birthday, Mrs. Hackett.
Oh.
Open it up, Sally. It looks interesting.
Oh, my. What a fancy box. Let's see. It's something light blue, satin, with lace.
Mm. Don't look very useful.
Oh, luscious, whatever it is.
Oh, it's a nighty and bed jacket from the family for when I go to the hospital. Isn't it beautiful? Oh, but they shouldn't care.
Well, there ain't nothing to cry about.
I know. I love it. I just think you can. Maybe I'm a little homesick.
Oh, honey. You really wish it had come from...
Miss Wright. Maybe we'd better go now.
Oh, yes. Oh, no, don't go.
Got work to do. I've always got work to do.
Yes, me too. Thanks for the recipe, Sally. Be seeing you. Bye, Kitty.
Oh, for goodness sake. Just because I... Well, Cinder, they're gone. But I'm not going to cry. I haven't anything to cry about. I'll have to put my presents and cards away, though. If Jim's forgotten my birthday... I don't want to remind him of. It's somebody's birthday. Her first time on birthday.
Mm-hmm.
What's the matter, Cinder? Sure, it's 7 o'clock. But what? Jim said he'd be late. Nothing to meow about. I guess that's him now. Forgot his key again.
All right, I'll be there in a second. Surprise!
Happy birthday!
Oh, goodness, thank you two. A cake with candles!
Uh-huh. Let's take it to the kitchen so that I can set it down and show you what it does when I wind up the pan. Now listen.
Oh, how cute. Look, it revolves, too.
Uh-huh.
You know, I'm at 4522 Wall Street. Just one big happy family. We can't miss a chance to have a party.
Is everybody coming? How wonderful.
Oh, that's the birthday spirit, Sally. Even if Jim... even if you and Jim don't believe in birthday parties, the rest of us do, so you'll just have to be agreeable.
Oh, it's sweet of you to do this, and I love it.
Oh, where's Mr. Carter? Not home from work yet?
No, he isn't. They're so busy at the office, he said he'd probably be late tonight, and... Oh, God.
What's the matter, Sally?
Well, I was just thinking... Well, if everybody's here, celebrating my birthday, and Jim comes home, well, he'll want to clean up and sort of catch his breath before a party, so if we could just take the things up to your place...
Well, look now, if she don't want us here...
Oh, Mrs. Hackett, it isn't that. Really, it isn't.
It's just that she doesn't want Jim to look like a heel or act like a heel. Or even feel like a heel.
Oh, Martha, please. That's not it at all. It's just
that... Oh, I'm beginning to think that this wasn't such a good idea after all.
Oh, it was. It's a wonderful idea, Mrs. Hackett, and I love it, but...
I'll take the stuff up to my place right away. And Mrs. Hackett, you tell everybody the party's up there. And... Oh, my.
Hiya, beautiful. Sorry I'm late, but I had some things to take care of on the way. Hey, what the heck goes on here?
In less than a minute, you'll hear the rest of today's story about Sally's birthday. But first, an important reminder to all of you who have a tiny baby and to any of you who are expecting one. For your guidance in caring for and training your baby, Mary Lee Taylor has a remarkable book she'd like to send you free. A beautiful 64-page book packed with information that every young mother needs, all approved by a well-known baby doctor. When you ask Mary Lee Taylor to send you the recipe booklet, From Soup to Dessert, ask her also for a copy of this valuable baby book. And now, back to the scene in Jim and Sally Carter's apartment when Jim came in and said,
Hey, what the heck goes on here?
Why, we're having a party. That's it. Just a party. We haven't had a party for a while, and we thought it'd be fun.
Just a plain party? Well, how come that cake with the candles? Looks like a birthday cake to me.
Yes, it does, doesn't it?
Oh, what if it does? I wanted to buy a cake. The only cake they had was this one with the candles onto it. So I bought it. Guess it'll taste just as good as any other cake.
Sure. And besides, we were just showing it to Sally. The party's really going to be up at my place. We were just leaving, Jim.
Oh, you were? Well, you know what? It's a funny thing, but just so happens that today is somebody's birthday.
You don't say.
Not really.
It sure is. It's Sally's birthday.
Oh, Jim.
Oh.
My.
Yes. Oh, my.
Of course, we don't go in for a lot of fuss, but, well, since it looks as though you've got everything anybody'd need for a party, might as well have one.
Well, now, this is more like it.
Here, Sally. Flowers for my best girl.
Oh, roses. Oh, darling, they're beautiful.
Ain't they pretty?
Lovely.
And sweets for the sweet.
Flowers and candy.
But you can only have one piece a day. You got to remember Junior's waistline.
I'll open it for the party. More presents?
Oh, just a catnip mouse for Cinder and... this package for the birthday girl. It's kind of intimate, and I didn't plan on having an audience.
Want us to leave, Jim?
Is it for the baby?
It certainly is not for the baby. And as far as I'm concerned, you can both stay right here for the opening.
Oh, what a fancy box. Oh, I'm so excited.
item. Let's see. Oh, it's something light blue, satin, with lace.
Mmm, sounds luscious.
Oh, it's a nightie and bed jacket for when I go to the hospital.
Well, what do you know?
Why, it's just exactly like...
Exactly like what I said I wanted. Jim, you're an angel. Oh.
Mrs. Carter, please. In front of all these people.
I almost feel like I'm looking in somebody's window.
I'll tell you what. Since this is Sally's birthday, why don't you have the party down here instead of in your apartment, Mrs. Rarick?
Well, I guess that could be arranged.
Yeah. Ain't it nice that the cake just happened to have candles on, too?
Well, Sally, happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Sally. Happy birthday to you.
Dropping in on Jim and Sally Carter again next week. But right now, here's something worth remembering. You can get a collection of wonderful recipes free if you'll do this today. Print on a postcard your name and address and the words soup to dessert. Send the card to Mary Lee Taylor, care of this station, or to Pet Milk, St. Louis, Zone 1, Missouri. And when you shop for groceries, look for the Pet Milk display and help yourself to one of the handy take-home recipe and meal planning folders featured with that display.
And speaking of meal planning, here's the meal we've planned for today. It's a low-cost, satisfying dinner, yet it's made up of only three dishes. And the recipes for all three are in the book that Del King has just told you about. First, tamale casserole, a hearty main dish with a Spanish flavor. Then, kidney bean salad, a salad that's a favorite with men.
And if you're out to please the men, you'd better have some bread and butter handy, too.
Would you settle for heated rolls and butter spread?
Oh, sure thing.
Fine. And for dessert, Danish fruit pudding and hot coffee or tea.
That sounds plenty good, Mary Lee. Only thing, I haven't tasted that Danish fruit pudding yet. I've heard rumors floating around this kitchen that it's...
give you an idea of what kind of dessert it is. And now, Here's how to make it. First, soften one envelope of unflavored gelatin.
Wait a minute now. Soften one envelope unflavored gelatin. Okay, go ahead.
In 1/3 cup of cold water.
In 1/3 cup cold water. Yep, I've got that.
Then heat to boiling.
Heat to boiling. All right, what are the things I heat to boiling?
2/3 cup of prune juice.
2/3 cup prune juice. Mm-hmm. What else?
1/3 cup canned fruit cocktail juice.
1/3 cup canned fruit cocktail juice. Oh, I'm beginning to see why that pudding tastes so good. Next.
2 tablespoons sugar and 1/8 teaspoon salt.
2 tablespoons sugar, 1/8 teaspoon salt. That all we heat to boiling?
Yes. You heat the fruit juices, sugar, and salt to the boiling point. Then you stir in the gelatin.
Stir in gelatin. Okay, then what?
Then add 2/3 cup of cooked, cut-up prunes.
Add 2/3 cup cooked, cut-up prunes. And that's what puts the dark little freckles in the pudding, huh?
That's right. And also add 1/3 cup of canned fruit cocktail.
1/3 cup. Canned fruit cocktail. For color and flavor, no doubt.
And the next step is to chill that mixture until it's slightly thicker than unbeaten egg whites.
Chill until slightly thicker than unbeaten egg whites. I guess a woman knows when a mixture is slightly thicker than unbeaten egg whites, huh?
Of course. Then you whip 1/3 cup of ice-cold pet milk until it's fluffy.
Whip until fluffy 1/3 cup ice-cold pet milk. And you'll be surprised at how easily this double-rich milk whips.
Then add to the whipped milk, 1 tablespoon lemon juice.
Okay. Add 1 tablespoon lemon juice.
And whip until stiff.
And whip until stiff. And that takes only a few seconds after you add the lemon juice, right, Miley?
That's right. Now, finally, fold the stiffly whipped milk into the gelatin mixture, put into a quart mold that's been oiled and rinsed with cold water, and chill until firm.
Oh, now, hold on, I'm lost. Let's see, fold the whipped milk to the gelatin mixture.
And put into a quart mold that's been rubbed with oil or rinsed with cold water.
Yeah. Okay. Then it's ready to chill, huh?
Mm-hmm. And when it has chilled until it's firm, you have enough Danish fruit pudding to make 4 generous servings. Oh, and by the way, in place of the canned fruit cocktail, you can, if you like, use canned crushed pineapple. And then just drain and save the juice and use the pineapple juice in place of the canned fruit cocktail juice.
But don't try to use any other form of milk in place of the pet milk. Guess that's an unnecessary thing to say. After all, you can't whip ordinary milk, and you certainly wouldn't want to use expensive whipping cream when you can whip pet milk and get the same results for a lot less money. And you probably know without my telling you that pet milk puts into that dessert more of the nourishing whole milk substances than you get from cream, so Naturally, you won't want to make Danish fruit pudding with anything but good, sweet pet milk.
And I think it's important to know, too, that pet milk actually triples in volume when whipped, while whipping cream doesn't quite double. So it isn't just the frisk cost that saves you money. And here's something I want you to be sure to remember. When you make Danish fruit pudding, do chill that gelatin mixture until it's just slightly thicker than unbeaten egg whites, but don't overchill it. And do fold the whipped pet milk into the gelatin mixture with easy, gentle stirs, so you won't force out any of the air you whip into the milk.
And if your husband is ever in one of those moods that even the best of husbands get into now and then, one of those nothing-will-please-me-today moods, you just use Mary Lee Taylor's fail-proof recipe for Danish fruit pudding, and chances are he'll have a happy and pleased grin before he takes the second spoonful. And now, I know it's almost time for today's recipe for happiness, but first, a word about next Saturday's program.
Well, next Saturday, our recipe is a very special one in honor of a very special day, Valentine's Day. Next Saturday, too, we'll have another grand story about Jim and Sally Carter. And starting next Saturday, I'll be talking to most of you in the Eastern and Central time zones a half hour later. So next Saturday, do be sure to check your local newspaper for the exact time.
And tonight, be sure to tune in to Vic Damone, starring on The Pet Milk Show. This big half-hour musical show brings you Vic Damone with radio's newest favorite, Kay Armon, the Pet Milk Serenaders, and Gus Henson and his Pet Milk Orchestra. So don't miss it. The time is tonight over most of these same NBC stations. And now, today's recipe for happiness.
Keep your face toward the sunshine, and the shadows will fall behind you. And now until next week, this is Mary Lee Taylor saying goodbye and happy homemaking.
Goodbye, Mary Lee Taylor, and good luck and good health to all of you from Pet Milk, the first evaporated milk. The Mary Lee Taylor program, sponsored by Pet Milk Company, is directed by Al Chance. This is NBC, the national broadcasting company.